डिप्टी सेक्रेटरी जनरल, देन विल गो फॉर द रोड मैप फॉर स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लान फॉर्मुलेशन, देन द समरी प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द बांग्लादेश रेड क्रिसेंट सोसाइटी स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लान 2021 टू 2025, देन वी गो फॉर द ओपन डिस्कशन एंड वी डेफिनेटली हियरिंग फ्रॉम यू एंड वी विल गो फॉर द फीडबैक कलेक्शन फॉर्म वेयर मे बी वी यूज द स्लाइडो वर्शन. Then definitely we'll wrap up and the closing remarks. This is the session brief outline from our side. So we'll go for the first session briefing side, which is the planning process and the review of the last strategic plan. So may I request our Deputy Secretary General, Mr. Rafiqul Islam, to say about these topics. So over to Mr. Rafiqul Islam, Deputy Secretary General of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much, Saima. And thank you everyone who joined from different part of the world. So I welcome you to this 1 hour session. Very good morning, good afternoon, and good evening who are online with us in this session. As Saima was mentioning, my colleague, that the BDRCS strategic plan is the last 20 years. We have been following a cycle of 5 years strategic plan. So our previous strategic plan, which has been adopted for 2017 to 2023 period, was considered as the 5th strategic plan of the National Society. So our vision, mission, and all activities are structured in 5-year cycle, as I said before. The 5th strategic plan expired on 31st December 2020. And the new cycle of strategic planning commenced from 21. The new strategic plan is the 6th strategic plan, the current one, which covers the period Saima mentioned, 2021 to 2025. That means for 5 years. So how we came to this 6th strategic plan, a evaluation of the 5th strategic plan completed, and the latest, the current strategic plan is all the recommendation and also the learning from this evaluation process being adopted or incorporated in the 6th strategic plan. And this strategic plan also we translated into 1 year's action plan for every year. Now also we have one national society, one operational plan for this one. And also this, the 6th strategic plan is the symbolic, is the symbolize of the long-standing mission, vision of the organization and further enhance it to ensure that the BDRCS remain as a dynamic and trusted local network of the members and volunteers that is fit for purpose, always there, and to accompany people and the communities. This 6th strategic plan provides in-depth guidance and priorities for the branches, the staffs, volunteers, and members, for the partners who will be working hand to hand to achieve the goals and target of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society. I would like to also highlight a couple of things, that our strategic plan is very much aligned with the IFRC strategy 2030. This will contribute towards achieving, or this is aligned with the agenda for renewal. As at the same time, this strategic plan also is in line or aligned with the uh, With the national plan of Bangladesh, I can say that it is in line. So with these few words, I would like to hand over the floor to Saima, and also I will invite you for tomorrow's session, where we'll talk about our operational plan, and that is going to take place at 1 p.m. CET and UTC time, and 2 p.m. Bangladesh time. Thank you very much. Over to Saima.
Thank you, sir, for your brief opening. So now I go for the roadmap for Bangladesh Red Crescent Society strategic plan formulation issue. Definitely we'll follow the guideline of the IFRC strategic plan formulation for 2030. So we are trying to follow all this part of the planning process. So I now request Mr. Nawaz Sharif, PMER officer of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society, to discuss about the roadmap of the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society strategic formulation process. Over to Nawaz.
Thank you, Samapa. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Great. So this is Nawaz, as Samapa was already introducing me, that I work for the PMER team in Bangladesh Red Crescent Society. So the strategic plan of BDRCS for the 2021-2025 period, it was formulated through a rigorous and systematic process. And this process started from the July of 2020 last year. So for over the six months of period, we developed the strategic plan in a constructive method. So first of all, we started in July through formulating different groups, especially the advisory group, which is comprised of our in-country partner national societies, IFRC and ICRC representatives. And also we had an advisory group or working group. So apart from the advisory group, there was a working group comprising the senior management, like directors and above officers and staffs from the national society. And also there was a sub-working group to assist this working group as well to formulate the process. And also there was a list of facilitators who will facilitate different sessions and consultation and throughout the coming few months. So afterwards, in August 2020, so we had a thorough desk review process, and we went for some vulnerability analysis, some overview and analysis that we had from our last strategic plan that was for 2017 to 2020 timeline. And then we had some other documents that we reviewed, like OCAC and also BOCA findings. And so afterwards, we also continued in September as well, this analysis and assessment process. And this also include identifying the internal and external stakeholders consultation. And also we prioritized our, defined our priority settings for how we'll go to the end. So afterwards, so we started drafting the strategic plan. And for this, we had to develop the five set SMART criteria to define organizational goals, missions, and visions. In November, we already had the draft strategic plan in our hand, and we went for the consultation. The consultation process we had with the through our working groups and also different stakeholders. So we finalized through endorsing and dissemination of the draft in different phases. So we collected feedbacks from our partners, our in-country national society staffs and volunteers, our branch governance, our headquarter governance. And also we had shared our draft strategy plan with our external non-movement partners as well for their feedback. And afterwards, then we finalized the strategic plan for the 2021 to 2025 timeline. And this after then we got approval from our governance, and then governance or managing board at the end of the last year in December. And now we are in the process of rollout and aligning this strategic plan with all our different meetings and consultation workshops that we try to introduce the strategic plan and its goals, objectives, outcomes with our different level of staff, governance, volunteers, and everyone. And that's how we are planning to implement this strategic plan. Yeah, thank you. Over to Samapa.
Thank you, Mr. Nawaz, for briefly discuss the roadmap which Bangladesh Red Crescent Society followed to formulation of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society 5-year strategic plans. So I'm going for the presenting you the very brief on the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society strategic plan. So after all this consultation process, we find out our vision and mission. So as our Deputy Secretary General said, we have last 4 years strategic plan and we review the strategic plan. So we found almost the vision and mission statement is almost similar to last 4 years. We just rephrasing some word because of the all still the vision is and mission is still valid for us. So our vision is to stand leading role as a humanitarian organization by mobilizing the power of humanity. And the mission is the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society, a volunteer-based humanitarian organization, endeavors to prevent and reduce the human suffering and save the improved lives of the most vulnerable and marginalized group by the providing effective and efficient services through mobilizing resources in emergencies and the normal. If you see the slides, so this is our main topics of our strategic plan inside our strategic books, which is that we have 3 goals for strategic hub, for the decentralization, 5 transformation, 6 humanitarian challenges, and 7 service. So each and every goals, we find 2 specific objectives. First goal is to enhance capacity to contribute towards saving life from disaster and crisis with a view of reducing adverse impact through the building resilience community, which is very much relevant to the disaster response and disaster risk management. So under the goal one, we have 2 specific objectives. So in the specific goal 2, which is the improved access to the equality health services for safe and dignified and healthy living. So this is very much relevant to the health issue, and we include the pandemic situation also. So under the goal 2, we have also the 2 specific objectives. For the time purpose, I'm not reading the specific objective. So under the goal 3, so this is the transformation into a strong national society, which is very much relevant to the national society development. And in the goal 3, we have also 2 objectives. And then the four topics is the strategic, 4 strategic hubs. We find out we need 4 strategic hubs to decentralize or localize the our services. So we next 5 years, we'll go for the 4 strategic hubs. So this is the area base, and we find the flood and cyclone and others and urban hazard. So we relevant 4 strategic zones with the different disaster or different response issue. So this is the 5 transformation for Bangladesh Red Crescent Society for next 5 years, which is very much relevant to the agenda of renewal of IFRC strategy 2030. So one is the financial sustainability, centrally and branches, increase the membership and volunteers at center, decentralization at all level, a trust and accountable local actor, increase partnership and collaboration at all level. This is our 5 transformation. So we find six humanitarian challenges. One is the flood and river erosion, then cyclone and storm surge, COVID-19 and other pandemics, climate change and environmental crisis, urban multi-hazard, internal and external migration and displacement. This is the six humanitarian challenges we find out with our different consultation and different study. So we find the seventh service sector, which is the restoring family links,
wash,
shelter and settlement, health, blood and first aid, health, blood, first aid and PSS, anticipatory action, humanitarian education, flood and livelihood. And this is the based in our community. So we find almost 32 targets for next 5 years, and we are trying to put all this target, how we reach next 5 years, and definitely we'll discuss the one plan issue on tomorrow's session, how we utilize more for reaching our target. So for the goal one target is basically the branch disaster team formation, moderate emergency operation center, which we call the UOC develop branch, will establish the local fund for the anticipatory action. And the nationwide caseload, we target the 10% of the nationwide caseload covered by the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society. We also target for the 100 million, the revolving fund for the any kind of disaster. So this is under goal one. And goal two, you may find some others target, which is we have target for 20% of the national demand for the safe blood supply. And we target for the psychosocial first aid and target for the health professional for 2000 person for the health professional. And we have also target to target for the institutionalized our health institution. So this is under the goal two. And goal three, you may find the goal three, the lots of target, which is relevant to the OCAC certification of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society and draft the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society law, branch development issue, and youth and volunteers development, resource mobilization, financial system development, and others branch development issue. So this is under goal three. We target the goal under goal three. So this is the BDRCS result matrix and the process, which I already mentioned, the three statistic goal, we have six objectives and the 22 outcomes and 45 outputs in all over. So the result matrix is available in BDRCS Bangladesh Red Crescent Society website. If you are interested, you may find there is full result matrix in Bangladesh Red Crescent Society website. So this is the sample of the result matrix. So I'm stop here for this. They start very brief on the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society 5 years strategic plan. So now I over to my technical colleagues for the feedback collection issue. So I over to Zarab Adib. I am our senior IAM officer, to get feedback from your side. Please respond the feedback on online system.
Thank you so much, Samapu, for giving me the floor. Okay, for this part, I think many of you know about the Slido. Many of you may not be aware about the Slido. Okay, so what you have to do, just I'll share a link with you all. Then you'll click on the link and you can see in the screen that there's a code. Okay, but after going the link, you have to put the code. See this, when you click on the link, it will redirect to a page like this. And see, joining as a participant, you will enter the code. I will share in the chat box. And then like we have three questions. The first question, it's actually multiple choice questions. The first question is like, what are the three key benefits of having the strategic plan of a national society? Then the question will come like this. Then you can select three options from this question. And from the next question, it's like a word web or something, like you can enter text. In the next question, like you will, so it is also like a text box, you can write your answer here. So check the chat box. So you'll get the link from the chat box. Please, everybody, check your chat box and you'll get the link. And follow the instruction I have already shown you by the PPT. Just a minute. So now I think you all can see the first question we have already shown you. So for the first question, we are going to take 1 minute. So please give the answer. I'm showing the screen here to 2 minutes. Okay, so we are going to give 2 minutes. So you can select three options from this question. As you can see the answer, we are sharing the screen, but don't get confused. Please go to the link and select the answer from the link. So those who have missed my instruction, I have already shared the link. Please don't get confused to see the screen. It is the result of what you are selecting. Okay, so go to the chat box. The link is there and the code is there. So go to the link and by entering the code, then you will be redirected to this question. Hello everyone, just apart from this survey, there will be a question and answer session. So if you guys have any question, then you can raise hand after this survey, then we'll take your question. Okay, so we are done with the first question. We are going to the next question. I think you all can see, like, there is a question, how best we can make our branches, volunteers and members inclusive into the SP process. So it is like a text option, so you can write two words. Don't get confused to see the screen I'm sharing. Actually, it's the result what you are writing. Okay, so just stay on the page, stay on the web page, and give your answer. We can see we have received only 15 answers. We're expecting more answers for the question. So those who are facing problem, I have shared the link in the chat box. Please go to the link and there is a code for you. Just enter to the link by giving the code. So we have received 16 till now. We have 20 seconds more for this question. Okay, so we are closing this poll and we are going for the next question. So I think you can see the next question, just how individual national societies can contribute to SP 2030 to its own SP. Maximum three words is also the same like previous question. So you'll get the text box. So you can put the answer as a text. So the question is how individual national societies can contribute to SP 2030 through its own SP. Okay, so in the question, actually it will be like how individual national societies can contribute to IFRC SP 2030. Through its own strategy plan. We can see that someone is putting the code here. Please try to write the answer of the question here. Actually, your feedback is really important for us. By getting your feedback, it will help us to take the decision, or it will give us some very important information. So we are expecting some good feedback from you guys. So last 10 seconds for this question. So we had these three questions. We might have a question and answer session. So those who have questions, you can ask your question there. And one more thing, one of our colleagues will discuss the result we have received from the survey. He will discuss it on the wrap-up session. So thank you, everyone. So this is the end of the session here. I'm closing the poll.
So thank you, Adip, for support us to the online feedback from you. And thank you all of you who joined with us the online feedback mechanism. So we will discuss the result on the wrap-up session. So now the floor is open for all of you. Any kind of question or any kind of opinion and anything you want to share with us, so and any feedback. So raise your hand first and we are trying to answer your question. From my side, I'm available, and definitely we have with us our Deputy Secretary General and I4C colleague and planning team on Bangladesh Red Crescent Society. All together, we will try to get back your feedback. So floor is open for all.
Assalamualaikum. I'm Nurul Amin.
Definitely, but before that, Ali is raise his hand. So floor open for Ali. So Ali, yes. Bhai.
Yeah, good afternoon and good morning and good evening, everyone joining from the world, around the world. So try to be initiator, the first question, but one of our colleagues already they started. But very short, how you measure the progress, the strategic plan.
So thank you, Ali. I may answer, then if needed, then Rujay Bhai will support me. So definitely in our last strategic plan, we have some shortfall, which we call with lack of the operational plan of each and every department. So this time we're trying to put the operational plan each and every year. We already did the 2021 and we are already complete the 2022. And then our premier team, they will organize a template for the progress tracking issue. So maybe the month of January, we will circulate the progress tracking sheet with all of our colleagues to tracking the progress of our target. So this is the mechanism from our side. So do you have anything? So thank you. So then the
thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ali. So Mr. Nurul Amin from Bangladesh.
Thank you, Appa. Thank you. Thank you. Excellent presentation and the good strategic plan for 2021 to 2025. It is the BDRCS. My question is, we have seen the last 2017 to till today, our legal base, every strategic plan years, we have planned to legal basis will be established or approval from the government, but still not our legal base is not recognized by the government. So what is we have seen that the legal base is the 21 to 25 will be again the newly draft legal base be formatted, and I think a lot of work last few years. But it's still not recognized. So we can hope the coming years will be recognized from the government side.
Yes, so I think our Deputy Secretary General is the right person to answer this question.
Thank you very much, Mr. Nurul Amin. One information I need to correct, that is, our legal base is a presidential order PO26 of 1973, which is the legal document of Bangladesh State Christian Society. What you are referring to, we have already submitted the revised one to the Bangladesh government or the competent authority to approve it. Since this is a part of Bangladesh constitution, our legal document is part of Bangladesh constitution, that's why it needs a process. Last almost 10 years, we have been struggling with the approval process, because that needs to finally goes from the legal Ministry of Legal Affairs to the Parliamentarian Committee, and Parliamentarian Committee will submit it to Parliament, and the Bangladesh Parliament will approve it. That's why it is taking so much time, because for each and every words and sentence, the file is back and fro coming from them. But we hope that it will, in due course, it will be passed by the Parliament. Okay, so our legal base is approved one, that is the PO26.
Okay. Thank you, sir, for your details briefing.
I have a supplementary question regarding on this issue.
So, Mohsin Bhai, I'll give you the floor. So, others colleague from joined with us from different national society, please raise your hand for sharing your experience. This is the Bangladesh Red Crescent Society homegrown strategic plan. So you may share with us your experience regarding on the strategic plan. So over to Mohsin Bhai, if you have any burning question.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. As per the strategic goal 3 under National Society Development, so already Nurul Amin Bhai said, but that is not basic point. Point is the Red Crescent Law. So already we have seen that that is also marked that we'll achieve Red Crescent Law by 2025, I mean the end of the strategic plan. So my point is here that, can you just tell us what is the update? Where is the position at this moment? And we have seen in the different issues in the government level. So they can raise this kind of issues very short time in the parliament, and it's passed. But we are struggling since 10 years. So is there, can you just tell us about some?
Thank you, Mohsin Bhai. So Mr. Mohsin is the director in charge of the RFL department of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society. I think our, so I think our Deputy Secretary General already mentioned the update of the new law of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society is in our cabinet division for final approval. But you know the Bangladesh government, so we need to back and forth the changing process is still going on. So if you need any update from our side, definitely we'll discuss bilateral in our office in Dhaka. So thank you, Mohsin Bhai. Sorry, any of you have any question? Colleague from others national society? Any suggestion for us or anything you may share? So if not, then we'll go for the, sorry. So Sanjeev from Swiss Red Cross, So you, floor for you.
Yeah, thank you, Sam. As you are looking for a suggestion, I want to just reflect on the action plan, joint action plan development process. I think you already mentioned a little bit, but this is a small suggestion for Bangladesh Red Crescent Society that the department should consider of developing their own operation plan at the beginning of each and every year. What is happening right at this moment, like all the PNSs are coming up their plans, and yeah, some of the departments have their own plans, and it looks like predominantly or heavily focused by PNSS plans. So I would rather like to see Bangladesh Red Crescent Society's different departments are having their own plan, and then PNSS are chipping in and contributing to fulfill or achieve that particular plan. And that is our overall target also. Thank you. Thank you, Saima. That's all.
Saima, may I respond to this one as well?
Definitely, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Sanjeev, for highlighting or raising this question. Yes, this is a concern. But as you know, that most of the PNS plan, that is not a PNS plan, that's been jointly developed by the partner national society and the concerned programs or the program people of BDRHS. Yes, when it comes population movement operation in Cox's Bazar, there are some technical problem, because there are most control is somewhere else, or BDRHS may not have that much, you know, direct involvement, as I say, in terms of, but again, there also nothing is decided or included in the plan without consultation or agreement of BDRCS. So there is a tendency, I know that, but we are very diplomatically managing those things. But as you know, that Bangladesh Red Crescent Society is in the driving seat in when it comes implementation or designing of the program. But yes, we also respect the partners' views and also their back donors' view. So I think you, I was able to answer your question, but you have raised a very valid thing and also very a bit sensitive thing, but it's okay, no problem. We are free to discuss on this. Thank you very much. Over to Saima.
Thank you, sir, and thank you, Shunjeep ji, for your question. Definitely, we'll discuss later on in our operational plan process. So, thank you, everyone. So I don't find any new hand raised, so we will go for the wrap-up session. May I request Mr. Odit Shah Durjoy, Senior Manager of National Society Development in IFRC Dhaka office, who is also very technically support us to prepare the strategic plan for BDRCS. So over to Durjoy Bhai.
Thank you, Samapa, and thank you, Bangladesh Red Crescent Society, for adding me in this session, to giving the chance to wrap up the session. I must say that the discussion I enjoyed a lot, and maybe I will try my level best to wrap up for everyone's benefit, so that we remind ourselves the whole discussion, and also that might help us for our learning process for this global NSD event as well. So we came to know from the Deputy Secretary General that this is the sixth strategic plan, which shows that BDRCS have a very good long culture of planning process. This is not something that they are doing it at this year as a first time. So that shows that BDRCS has a long culture of planning exercise. We also came to know from our PMEA colleagues that the roadmap of the strategic plan formulation what are the steps they followed, and what levels of consultation they maintain. And definitely in various stages with a lot of partners' involvement, external engagement with the government, various has maintained a coordination structure to formulate the strategic plan to make sure that all levels are engaged in the discussion and analysis process. In the roadmap, they also mentioned about the surveys, and they did some review and analysis to come to a prioritization process. One thing I actually noted that is not only preparation and agri that has gone through an approval process as well from the governing board of the National Society before they went for the rollout. And and they also have some ceremonial things like the launching of the operational plan. So in my little understanding, this roadmap has followed very nicely the standard the guideline of any organization strategic planning formulation process. Then the director of planning and development department, briefly presented the summary of the strategic plan, which has a very good like things to remember, like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, with three strategic goals, then four strategic hubs, where the strategic hubs are mainly to ensure that BDRC is going through a decentralization process closer to the communities. Then they have mentioned five is representing five transformations, so where they mentioned that they are trying to link up with the IFRC strategy 2030. And also they mentioned that the agenda for renewal, where I think one of the colleagues mentioned that what is the tracking mechanism they have in place or they are planning. I think that is something Ms. Saima mentioned, that they are in a process to track the progress, and that will also link up with the agenda for renewal of the IFRC. They have also mentioned the humanitarian challenges that the country is facing and how it is linked up with the global trends like the pandemics and epidemics. There are some targets rightly mentioned. I think that shows their courage of the National Society. Be bold to agree on some targets with timeline. And definitely that will, I would say that will push BDRCS to ensure that there is a tracking mechanism of the progress. Otherwise they couldn't have included the targets with timeline. I think that's a very good initiative by the National Society. A couple of things in the targets I noticed, I might miss some points, but some key points were the financial sustainability, the response readiness, transparency, accountability, and also the decentralization, where Ms. Saima mentioned about the branches, where they have a couple of targets aiming at the branch level. May I request to share the survey findings of the online survey, where we saw that the participants were really engaged. Maybe I can see that maybe roughly 30 to 40 participants engaged in the survey. The reason I understood from them, the reason to add this survey was that helps BDRCS and also the event, the global NSD event, to capture the learnings in a structured way. Because as a process, BDRCS will share this the notes of the meeting as well as the survey finding with the global NSD event organizing committee, so that becomes the some evidence of our engagement, the collective engagement. So you can see in the screen 83 votes in three polls. So in the first questions, there are lots of benefits of having a strategic plan. And I think many of you have agreed that it guides the leadership with missions and vision. So that's something very important things we learned from this session, that if the leadership is guided by a structured mission and vision, that helps the National Society to move forward and be a trusted partner for service delivery. Then there are other elements which have been selected, like it helps to prepare the operational plan, it helps the National Society for Branding, etc. So may I go request for the second question, please? Yeah, I can understand we are 2 minutes over time and some of the colleagues have to leave. Thanks for those colleagues who have time constant and need to leave. We'll finish in next 2-3 minutes time. This word cloud, you can see like how we can engage the branches and the volunteers and members, definitely through the consultation, sharing and participation and engagement, and also increasing the collaboration and using some participatory approach. So I think this will also be an evidence for us for this global NSD event to utilize for other other national societies as well. On the last question, if we see that how we can link up the strategic plan with IFRC strategy 2030, so that has emphasized on the coordination and alignment, the big word. So that means this has come up many times, I guess. So I think ultimately we are the family of 192 national societies, and Bangladesh Red Crescent Society has rightly taken the initiative to from the very beginning, because we have to contribute to the global IFRC strategy 2030. We have 9 years, but they have planned these things from the very beginning, and with an aim in the next 5 years to contribute to the global movement. So for that, we need the alignment and coordination. So I think that's it to wrap up the session. Feel free if there is anything I missed, or if there is anything. Maybe now I pass the floor to Tamaka.
So thank you, Rujay Bhai, for wrap up the whole things, which is captured very nicely. Thank you once again. So we are running through the time, so I hand over to our Deputy Secretary General for closing remarks, then we will close the session. So over to Mr. Rafiqul Islam, Deputy Secretary General of Bangladesh Red Crescent Society.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Saima, and also the team who supported this event. And also, the big thanks goes to everyone who were connected with us and contributed in voting and in the learning process. As all speakers and presenter has mentioned, and you have seen that the summary being presented, I will request and hope we are going to share the electronic copy of our strategic plan with all 192 national societies to see and also to encourage and to get feedback as well from them, from there. That would be also a learning for us. So, and as our presenter have been mentioning that this is a home ground developed strategic plan. Last couple of strategic plan we developed ourselves in the BDRCS with the technical support from our partners, particularly Federation and partner national societies working with us, and also ICRC colleagues here. So thank you very much for listening, and we invite you for tomorrow's session. With that, I would like to conclude today's session. Have a great day, good day, and good evening to everyone. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, sir, and thank you all who joined with us from Bangladesh Red Crescent Society and the Partners National Society and the others National Society and the IFRC colleagues. So thank you very much to join with us. Definitely all of you are joined with tomorrow's session, which is Bangladesh time 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., the one plan for one national society. So thank you once again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Yo. Apa, apnakeo dhonnobad.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all.
Thanks to all, and I am leaving.